Now, the absolute necessity of being a woman of action, the need to practice, learn, innovate, come up with your own social solutions, learning by doing, and yet be an individual at the same time, takes maintenance of these skills. It takes takes practice, learning, and maintenance of the skills that you're going to learn. When we talk about flirting, and we talked early on about games and how games can be useful and positive and life expanding, intellectual growth, the area of sexual attraction has this natural, organic nature to it that is still nonetheless a skill. Just like acting is a skill, or being a stand-up comic is a skill, or being a dancer is a skill. It's not quite a skill you can read about in a book. It's something you have to do. And that's one of the big reasons we thought coming out with this entirely free program for you in two parts. Part one comes along with our newsletter, and part two comes along with a free month's membership in our forums, that learning by doing is really essential for getting these principles down, not just reading them in a book, but actually going out and trying them in your very real life. I thought, part of wrapping up this section is going to be you're gonna need to learn to test men. We mentioned earlier that you have to test men for their character, but you also test them for their level of masculinity. How much of a man are they, and how mature are they? Both of these things need to be tested. And if you're going to test a man, you're probably going to have some conversation with him at least. So I thought it might be kind of interesting for us to play around a little bit for you with some ideas, and you'll be coming up with some of your own, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. But translating man language.
As one example, testing can sometimes be counterintuitive. Sometimes you're offering him an opportunity to be a gentleman rather than, you know, really testing him, you know, and really putting up the gauntlet for him to run. Sometimes I've been out with women who are very, very, you know, accomplished and strong people. Maybe you'd call them warriors, you know. And there's a point sometimes in the date when this very strong, accomplished woman says, "Oh, it's raining. What are we going to do? Who will get the car?"
And there are no cabs.
There are no cabs. And I know that she wouldn't normally do that. Normally she'd be like, "Let's get a cab. Let's go here." But she's giving me an opportunity to step up and say, "I will get the cab," you know. And so sometimes it's you know, and we're going to be talking to a lot of women in our society who can get things done themselves, can take care of things themselves. And sometimes the test is not making him run the gauntlet, you know, or being tough. It's giving him an opportunity to step up, you know, and step back yourself. And, you know, we talked earlier about is that demeaning to the woman? And of course, it's not. This is all natural stuff that happens in courtship, but it's sometimes counterintuitive.
If you're observing ego as a woman is turned off, mm-hmm. then you're not awake and aware of all this invisible right. stuff that's going on in the psychology. Mm-hmm. So you might not be aware that the man that you're interested in romantically would feel great about himself and be more attracted to you if you gave him a chance to get the cap,
right?
Instead of getting it yourself.
Right.
But
right.
with observing ego turned on, yep. you could say, "Aha, yep. I see an opportunity yep. to let this guy feel more masculine and right. therefore like me more."
Yep. And there's always the endless debate, you know, should you open a door for a woman or she can open
yes.
her own door and that kind of stuff. And if you're in a dating situation, of course he should open the door for
you.
He would be happy to do He would be happy to do that for you, and it's not demeaning to anyone to have him do that.
Could you open it yourself?
Yes,
you can. Of course.
Doesn't make you any less.
Yes.